Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today I wanted to share some updos. It's getting hotter outside and these will help get your hair up and off your neck. Let me know which one you like the best down below in the comments section. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell as always, and let's get started. For this hairstyle, begin by parting the hair wherever you normally prefer. Next, pick up a small section of hair on the left side of the part and divide it into three smaller pieces for the braid. Create a Dutch braid by crossing the side strands under the middle strand. This will make the braid sit out on top of the head instead of going under. After the initial stitch of the braid, begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid so it trails down the left side of the head. Cross the right strand under the middle, bring in a new section of hair and cross it under into the middle strand. Then cross the left strand under the middle, pick up a new section and cross it under into the middle strand as well. Continue crossing the side strands under the middle strand while incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. Once the braid reaches to the ear and you've brought in hair up to this point, now stop incorporating new sections of hair into the braid and continue braiding the hair in a regular three-strand braid. Cross the right strand under the middle, then cross the left strand under the middle. Now cross the right strand under the middle again. Then once the braid reaches near the ends and the braid extends around the back of the head towards the center back, slide a bobby pin over the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now repeat the same steps as before and create a second Dutch braid with the hair on the right side of the head. Pick up a section of hair next to the part line and divide it into three smaller sections. Cross the side strands under the middle strand to begin a Dutch braid. Incorporate new sections of hair into the braid after the initial stitch, continuing the braid down the right side of the head. Then cross the left strand under the middle, pick up a new section and cross it under into the middle strand as well. Cross the right strand under the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under into the middle strand. Then cross the left strand under the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under and into the middle strand as well. Cross the right strand under the middle, bring in a new section of hair and cross it under into the middle strand. Then cross the left strand under the middle, pick up a new section and cross it under into the middle strand as well. Cross the right strand under the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under into the middle strand. Once the braid reaches to the ear, and you've brought in hair up to this point, now stop incorporating new sections of hair into the braid and continue braiding the hair in a regular three-strand braid. Cross the right strand under the middle, then cross the left strand under the middle. Now cross the right strand under the middle again, then cross the left strand under the middle. Now cross the right strand under the middle again. Once the braid reaches near the ends and extends around the back of the head and meets the other braid at the back, slide a bobby pin over the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now, once both braids are done, bring the two braids around to the back of the head and tie them together using a clear elastic band. Then remove the bobby pins from the ends of the braids. Now create the bun portion of the hairstyle. So combine the rest of the hair together and use a hairband to tie off the hair into a low ponytail underneath the braids. On the second wrap of the hairband though, only pull the hair partway through to create a loop in the hair, leaving the ends on top of the bun so they're hanging out the top side. Then bring those ends down over the looped part of the bun and tuck them back around the hairband underneath the bun. The hairband will hold the hair in place without needing to use another hair elastic. Be sure to do this part carefully so the hair stays smooth as it's wrapped back down and tucked in. You can go back over the bun and spray it with hairspray, and then gently run a wide tooth comb over the bun to ensure it's smoothed down. Now go back over the hairstyle and detail it. Pull on small sections of hair around the crown to loosen them out of the elastic just a little bit. This will create some volume and texture around the crown of the head.
Then you can go back over both of the braids and gently pull on the edges to loosen the braids a little bit. This will make them look wider and more full, so they'll look bigger and be easier to see. For this hairstyle, begin by placing your part wherever you normally prefer. Now divide out any hair that you'd like to leave out to frame the face. Combine the rest of the hair together at the nape of the neck. Then smooth down the hair using a comb so it's more evenly combined and there aren't any bumps or gaps in the hair. Begin twisting the hair together towards the right side. Now bring the hair upwards and lay it against the back of your head. Take a claw clip and clamp this over the twist near the bottom. This clip that I'm using is from my store, Missy Sue Shop. I'll leave a link down in the description box. Once the hair is clipped up, take some hairspray and spray this over the ends of the hair. Then smooth down the hair using a comb so it's more evenly combined and there aren't any bumps in the hair. Now continue twisting the hair together towards the right side. Create a bend in the hair at the top of the head and curve the ends back down so they're going back down on the right side of the clip. Now you're going to pin the twist in place. So take some bobby pins and slide these into the twist wherever you're holding the hair down with your fingers. Place them around the outside of the twist and continue adding in pins until the hair feels secured in place and isn't going to fall loose. I used about 5 or 6 different pins for mine. And once it feels nice and tight, go back over the twist and gently pull on small sections of hair to loosen them out of the twist just a little bit. This will make it look larger and more full, giving the style a bit of texture and volume. You can pull on as much or as little of the hair as you'd like to make it as large as you'd prefer. The higher on the head the hair is pinned and pulled, the more easily it'll be seen from the front. Spray the style with a medium hold hairspray to continue detailing the style and to help smooth down any flyaways. I think this updo is so unique and fun and a really great way to style your hair to stay cooler during the hot summer months. For this hairstyle, begin by parting the hair where you normally prefer. I've parted my hair on the right side. Now divide out the 2 front sections of hair. From the part line down to each ear, divide this hair out by bringing it forwards to use later on. Now from the tops of both ears, create another part line by sliding the fingers down along the occipital bone above the nape of the neck to divide off a section of hair underneath. With the remaining top section of hair, combine this together for the first part of the hairstyle. This will form the base of the bun. So take a hairband and wrap this over the section, only pulling the hair partway through on the last wrap of the elastic. The hair should form a little bun at the bottom back of the head with the ends hanging down underneath. Now go back over the hair at the crown to detail it. Spray it with hairspray to smooth down any flyaway pieces and gently pinch and pull on small sections to create some volume and texture around the crown. You can also go back over the little looped part of the bun and pull the hair in opposite directions to kind of spread it out and make the bun a little bit bigger. Now find the hair at the nape of the neck that was previously separated out and split this into 2 equal sections so you have a right and a left section. Bring these 2 pieces over the top of the bun and tie them together. Cross the left side over the right and then bring the ends of the left side around the right. Then pull the ends in opposite directions to tighten the hair against the head on top of the bun. Then use a bobby pin to secure the knot in place, so gently weave the pin back and forth through the hair so it grips both the hair from the knot and the hair from the head so it feels like it won't fall loose. Then take the ends that are hanging down from the looped bun and repeat the same steps as before, tying them around each other. Divide them into 2 equal sections, a left side and a right side. Bring the 2 sections around the sides of the bun to the top and cross the left side over the right side. Then bring the left ends up and around the right side, pulling the 2 ends in opposite directions to tighten the hair against the head above the bun. Now wrap the ends back around the sides of the bun so they meet back together underneath. And to ensure they stay in place, take a clear elastic band and tie the two ends together underneath the bun. You can also use bobby pins to pin this hair in place underneath against the nape of the neck. Now with the two front sections of hair, we're going to bring these over the bun individually. So start with the section on the right side and twist the hair together, then drape it around the side of the head, laying the ends over the top of the bun. Pinch and pull on the twist just slightly to separate out the twist before pinning it in place with a couple bobby pins. Then take the hair on the left side of the head that was previously left out, divide out any hair that you'd like to leave out to frame the face, and then twist the section together as well and drape it around the left side of the head, laying it over the top of the bun as well. Pin the twist in place with a couple bobby pins, making sure to hide and pin the ends as well. I love buns like this one because they always end up looking really soft and delicate, but they're never too complicated to replicate.
That wraps up today's tutorial. Let me know in the comment section which one you like the best. Like and subscribe if you're new, click that notification bell, then you'll be notified every time I post a new video and you'll never miss one. And I will see you next time.